Once the opportunity arose for him to close the show, he did it in emphatic style.
Whatever he hits falls.
Andrew McCart, IFL TV in association with MTK Global. I'm here in Manchester to announce Katie Taylor versus Lyndon Dartu, but also on the card. I said that right, didn't I?
I don't know. I don't even think I can say it.
Lyndon Dartu, we'll run with that. With me, I've got Felix Cash. Felix, you've got a tough fight yourself against Jack Cullen. Did you watch his fight against Jack Harden? What's your thoughts on the fight?
Listen, I watched the fight with John Harden. He done what he had to do, and you know, no disrespect to John Harden Jr. He's not Felix Cash, so you know, listen, he done his job and he done what he had to do. But listen, when I'm in the ring with him, it's going to be a whole different ball game, and we'll see how he reacts when I start hitting him, and see how he reacts then.
You said at the press conference said that he's been chinned before.
Yeah.
I mean, you get in the ring with him, you're going to do the same. Do you believe you get the stoppage against somebody like Jack?
Well, I do believe I can, but you know, boxing's a funny sport. You know, you go in one game plan, you could do a lot of things, but when it comes to fighting, you got to do it. But I truly believe, and I'm fully confident enough that, you know, I will do the job on Jack and get him out there before the 12 rounds is up.
Jack isn't the one in the middleweight. He's 6'3".
I think he's taller than that. He's a tall, lanky one, I'll tell you that.
So who are you getting for sparring for this? I mean, it's a tough sparring. I've got
Craig Richards in the gym. He's obviously down at Matchroom Gym training with us. I've got John Dockey. I know he's southpaw, but he's tall, rangy, and I get a few other people in. But you know, I'm just at the end of the day, it's a fight, and we're just going there and we'll have a fight, and we'll see what it cracks.
Obviously, a good domestic fight coming off title on the line, sort of thing. But what's next for you? If all going well on November 2nd, what are you aiming for?
Well, listen, I'm aiming to take him out first, and you know, we take one fight at a time. You know, boxing's a funny business, isn't it? So you know, we'll see what's next. We'll see what opportunity arises. You know what I mean? If something big comes up, I'll take it. You know, but if not, then we'll have to go down a different avenue. But we'll have to wait and see. Just got to do my job here on the 2nd of November, and then we'll see what's next.
I've got to ask. Obviously, you said different avenues and whatnot in boxing. We've seen loads of fighters go down different routes, but are you one of them traditionalist fighters that maybe Commonwealth title, then British title, then European and so forth and so on? Is that
I'd like obviously to get a British, you know, I'd like to win a British, but you know, if something else comes in, something else, I'll go there, but it all depends what it is, but I'd like to get a British, yeah.
Liam Williams is the British champion. Do you think he'll vacate by the time you get up there?
Well, he's looking at some world title. I think people are saying he's moving back down, but whatever he does, if he's still about, we'll talk after a deal with Cullen.
Obviously, final question. You're up in Manchester November 2nd. What can the Manchester fans expect from you on fight night?
It's going to be all action, put it that way.
All action fight.
All action.
Good stuff. Well done, Felix Monk.
Good man. Thanks a lot, yeah.
TV. Thanks very much, mate.
Thanks.
Once the opportunity arose for him to close the show, he did it in emphatic style.
Whatever he hits falls.